Hey everybody, John here. Welcome to Monday Mack. Matthew is on a little reprieve with his lady. So while he's having fun, I'm stuck in the city, still working, cracking an ice cold Spindrift, just sipping. Because Matthew's gone, I'm going to do the Monday Mack by myself, but I'm going to do it a little different. And the reason is we just released a new single called Drinkin In Work, and we were a little busy. I filmed a little thing called Empty House Concerts over the weekend. Please go check that out. It's on the YouTube channel. Also, go check out Drinkin In Work. It's out everywhere. But all this was going on, and I forgot to listen to any new songs. So on this recording, I'm going to listen to 10 seconds or 15 seconds of random new songs that are on the new Music Friday Spotify playlist, and also Release Radar. So I'll do 5 and 5. So first, I'm on Release Radar, so let me start with a demo that Daft Punk put out featuring Julian Casablancas and the Voidz. So I'm going to click on it, and then I'm going to speed in the middle and just listen to 10, 15 seconds and just give my opinion on that. I might listen to this later. I already know I'm going to like this. Well, I like it. I like the way that sounds. I'm only giving myself 10, 15 seconds. That might have been 20, just because I was enjoying it. But that is Daft Punk, Julian Casablancas, and the Voidz called Infinity Repeating. It's a 2013 demo. Decent song. 7.3 out of 10. All right, so now let's do Angel Olsen. This is all Release Radar. Angel Olsen, My Reverie. Has to be Reverie. If it's not, I apologize. I mean, that sounds like really pleasant elevator music, but I don't have an actual idea what the song is from that. So I'm going to give it a 5 out of 10 just because I'm not sure. But it sounds good. It sounds better than the boring shit she was recently just putting out. So I'm excited to hear that full song. Number 3, my boy, Paul Cauthen, my guy. One of our competitors and one of our contemporaries when it comes to a newer version, a not bro country, but definitely a pop-friendly, but still has its integrity version of country. Let me get these stickers up. Let me get these stickers shown. All right, so this is called Home Team by Paul Cauthen. Excited to hear it. Alright, so I feel like that's sampled from somewhere. That's like the fucking Pop Some Tags. Ain't that what the fuck's his name? Malamore? I swear to God I don't remember his name. I'm not trying to be funny. Macklemore. That sounds like a Macklemore song. So Paul, I gotta listen to that full song. I don't want to judge you off of that, but not liking what I heard. Just because it sounds like they're ripping off Macklemore, and that's just a weird thing to do. But I do love Paul Cauthen, so I'm gonna give him the benefit of the doubt and say it's a 5 out of 10. I just got to hear what that's about. All right, Release Radar. Oh, so I will talk about this song because I already heard it. And I already put it in rotation. It's called Nudista Mundial 89. It is Alan Palomo featuring Mac DeMarco. And I'll just cut a little bit on. I like this song a lot. Oh, fuck, it went away. Fuck. Oh, here it is. Let's skip to the end. Really nice song. Song's a fucking party, and it's Mac DeMarco's best song since This Old Dog, the album, came out, and a couple of songs on there are really great, but what a bop this song is, man. If Mac DeMarco put out a dance album, it'd probably be the best dance album in the last, Beyonce's dance album was really good, but to me, it'd probably be one of the best dance albums ever. So more of this, Mac, please. I know this isn't your actual song, but, like, do this. This is fucking awesome. And this is, from what I understand, Alan Palomo's first song ever. So to get a Mac DeMarco co-sign and feature, holy shit, man. The dude must be something else. But this song's great. I don't know who's the main songwriter of the two. It's just written by those two, so hopefully we hear more from both of them. It's seriously, and I don't even know what they're saying in the song for the most part, but it's I'm gonna give it an 8.9 out of 10, and it might be higher if I translate some of the words. Fucking great song. I think that's the fourth from Release Radar. Let me jump to number 5. I don't want to hear a Liam Gallagher cover. You know what? I've had enough on this. I will give a shout out to Baxter Derry. I'm drowning in these urine lakes. I like Baxter Derry. All his songs are him. Like really, really nice bridges and choruses. And then him in the verse saying the most random British shit you ever heard in your life. But Celebrate Me, Baxter Derry. 6.8 out of 10, just because it's a lot of fun, but it's one of my least favorite singles from him. But it's still a lot of fun. I like that dude. All right, now let's go to the songs that I don't know. This isn't Release Radar. Release Radar is more tailored towards my preference, so let's do this a little quick, because I'm, alright, All My Life, J. Cole and Lil Durk. I've been doing a lot of Lil Durk research for me after that King Von thing that me and Matthew talked about a couple weeks ago. Dougie, you told me you've been on some positive, no. Well, I don't believe him, but, you know, I don't know if I heard enough. I definitely wanted to hear J. Cole's verse. I skipped to a little Durk verse just to keep it. I'm not going to do that on here. So I will listen to the song after because I do like some J. Cole. And I don't mind some Lil Durk either. So, but from what I can tell, this is a 4 out of 10. But it might change. All right, let's Jonas Brothers, Summer Baby. Damn it. Ah. Ah, they almost had me. I was like, that's a nice chorus. Don't like that, whatever the fuck that was, that feelings for you part. I guess the tag, I don't know, but I don't know. I've been a songwriter since I was, I guess, 19 or 18, and I don't know what any parts of songs are called, but I didn't like that fucking part. But it, you know what? I got a soul spot for the Jonas Brothers. The chorus sounded nice. 5 out of 10. I don't know if I'll listen back to that, but, ooh, 30 Seconds to Mars new song. Ugh. All right, here we go. I want to hear what this drop sounds like. That's a 2 out of 10. Fuck that song. I can't get into that, man. He's such a cornball. And he thinks he's Jesus. It's just like, shut the fuck up. Good actor. I like that song Kings and Queens by them. Or whatever it's called, if that's what it's called. And then, what's that song? Bury Me, Marry Me. Whatever. Fine. I guess he's a actor, he's a good musician. But fuck that song. That song was terrible. 2 out of 10. All right, let's get two more. Life Goes On, Ed Sheeran featuring Luke Combs. Ugh. When I hear your name, I think of love. So tell me how my life goes on with you gone. I suppose I sink like a stone if you leave me now. I want to hear what your voice is going. No, thank you. And then last song. There's not really too many people I'm interested in as the further I go down. You know, the only song I actually know, and this speaks to my, I guess, my R&B ignorance. The only song I know, or whatever genre, I don't know anything from Janelle Monae. But I've heard of her, but I don't know any of her music. So this song's called Lipstick Lover. This will be the last song we listen to. Let's figure it out. Lipstick Lover. I really got a thing for my lipstick lover. Lover, 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 lover. I do anything for my lipstick lover. Lover, 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 lover. I like lipstick on my neck. Leave a sticky icky in a place I won't forget. I like. Well, that sounds very typical of a. That's not what I thought I would hear. I don't know. I feel like I. And, you know, it could be better. People talk a lot about her being, like, really talented. But to me, that just sounded like a Rihanna song. With a, like, a, you know, with a less Caribbean, islandy sounding vocal. So I don't know, what is that? Would that be a 3 out of 10? 3.1 out of 10. So that's it. This is the Monday Mack this week. Matthew will be back for the podcast on Wednesday. Thank you for watching. Drinking and Work is out everywhere. Go listen to that, please, for the love of God. I don't want to go to work anymore. I'm still getting work emails. I'm literally on hour, so you could see. It's an Outlook email. I'm literally on hour, I don't even fucking know, 11 of working. I got to be in at 6. So, I'm still fucking working. So, please listen to the songs. Please like and subscribe so I can do this. Talk to you later. Thank you.